are very simple. Like volleyball, I cannot hit the ball personally more than once. Like tennis, the ball is allowed to bounce if it's a heavy hit, but it cannot bounce. Cannot hit it more than once. Your team has 3 hits to get it over the net. All right, go ahead. That's fine. Yep. That's good. You got 3 hits. Good kill. Double bounce. Then double bounce. Double bounce would be their point. They serve again. All right, and the biggest thing, once the game gets going, sometimes the kids forget, oh, I have all 3 hits. Want to rip it back and forth, but you just kind of dial it back and bring them home and remind them of those rules. Right. Good hit. Would have been out, or would have been the other team's ball. So you get this general idea. Now, as we turn it up a little bit, the one big rule that I had a couple of my mind guys figure out. The ball is only allowed to bounce once. So if I bounce it on my side and send it over, now the other team can't play it out in the air. So as you get volleys going back and forth, you may get a kid that as the ball is coming to me, I might bounce it on my side, get some crazy spin on it, now the other team has to play it right out of the air. They have to utilize their 3 hits. They have to get that 4-on-10 to kind of slow the ball down a little bit. On this little rep right here, try to get it if you can. Get a spike, get it to bounce on your side before sending it over. You are allowed to do it on this side. There you go. Makes it a little more difficult. Now they have to use a little bit more teamwork to play it. Now, right now, Mark will be in front of the spike line. We need to call that. Don't hit. The last thing, just to take a little low motion to forget that. It is allowed to bounce in. So when you're taking it, that's within 5. Even if it bounces out of bounds, now I can send it back to play and we keep it going.
Just 1% of not.
No, yeah, it's what in between you hit. So you hit it, it can bounce. You can come over, he can hit it, it can bounce, and then you can hit it over. As you ramp it up, you can take those bounces away, but again, it starts with kind of a big concept of a game that we go in and we fine tune it and we modify it from there. So from this, when we transition to regular volleyball, we would start with a volleyball net. This ball, same rules. So now the only difference is the net is higher. Then after a class of that, we get this ball out, we bring in a volley light. Same rules, ball can still bounce. So they're still working on their skills, they're getting more reps at it. Then on the last, if we have a 7-day unit, this is day 1 and 2. Day 3 is on a volleyball court. Day 4 is when a volleyball still is bouncing about. And then 5 to 7 is a regular volleyball unit. And then we rest it. All this lead up to it makes those last games. Those games are awesome because it's still has success in a modified setting. Now they just transfer over into a regular volleyball unit.